Hey guys, so recently I was sitting at my desk twiddling my thumbs, and I thought, you know what I should do? I should make a quadtree image compression algorithm. So here we are. A quadtree is a tree where each node has four children. Simple, right? Apply this to a 2D plane and you get something that looks like this. Each square represents a node, and each inner square represents a child or a subchild. So a child's child. Anyway, this can repeat recursively indefinitely. So how do you apply this to an image? That's simple. First, you ensure the image is perfectly square and has a resolution of a power of 2. You know, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, etc. We do this to ensure we can divide by 2 on every step of the way. Once the image is square, we can construct a quadtree which represents the image pixel by pixel. We can do this by dividing the image into its four corners and storing the top left pixel coordinates of each segment. Then we can do the same thing on each of those four segments recursively until we reach the 1 pixel level. At this point, we hit rock bottom and can't subdivide anymore. So we just assign the pixel color to that node and quit out of the function. This constructs a quadtree that will look exactly like the source image. I think it's about time to give this guy a test run. Here's a nice bitmap image that is about 8 megabytes in size. Let me run our algorithm on it and serialize the quadtree into a binary file just to see how much we compressed our original image. Oh, well, I think the problem is that since we're saving a whole lot more data per pixel, this won't exactly compress the image but inflate the size in memory by about 10 times. That's not the intended purpose for a compression algorithm, so we have to figure out a way to slash that number a bit. There are some optimization steps I can make to the serialization process, but first I'd like to try something else. The first method I'm going to try is to compare the colors of each child of a node to their average color. If they are similar within a certain threshold, I can simply merge them into their parent node. This way, I can make 4 pixels into 1, and we have achieved compression. This method essentially reduces the resolution of areas with low detail and maintains the resolution of areas with a lot of detail. Let me try this out one more time with a suitable threshold value. Let me try this again with a bigger threshold. Okay, looks like we're at about half the size of the other two, but still 4 times the size of the original bitmap. So, hold on for a minute. So far, I created a very lossy compression algorithm that not only reduces the quality of the image horribly, but also increases the file size considerably. Okay, time for some optimizations. So currently I'm storing the entire quadtree in a file with recursive classes, and each quadtree instance has several variables for color and depth. The big red flag here is the recursive classes. One empty class takes up 4 bytes as far as I could tell by my tests. If we consider that to save a color we only need 3 bytes, just the class alone more than doubles the required space per pixel. I'll write a function to get all the nodes with actual color data in them from the quadtree, and I'll save this list of nodes as 3 arrays. An array of colors, an array of node sizes, and an array of positional data. This way, I can store one node using only 8 bytes. Compare that to the 19 bytes required per node from before, and you have yourself a solid improvement. I'm going to give this one more go to see what kind of an improvement I get with a reasonable threshold. Wow, now that's slightly compressed. By the way, I can perform further lossless compression on this image by putting it into a zip file. This way the image becomes smaller than even a PNG. One downside to this compression is that if we try to store the image losslessly, then the size becomes larger than bitmap. This is because bitmap stores a list of color values taking up 3 bytes per pixel. Our quadtree takes up 8 bytes per node, so if all the nodes are the same size as pixels, the size is just about doubled compared to the bitmap. The further we compress the image, however, the more space we save, leading to tiny file sizes in the kilobytes with a high compression threshold. Anyway, here's the full source code. I'll put the whole project on GitHub for anyone interested in taking this any further or to simply check out what I've done in detail. There are some things that can be done, in my opinion, to improve upon this algorithm. Firstly, you might notice the resulting image looks a little blocky when the threshold is set too high. This can potentially be fixed by fiddling with the merging of colors. You could try to implement a dynamic threshold or threshold range where the smaller the node, the merging code accepts more of a color difference. And then, when the nodes become larger, the threshold is decreased to ensure a high level of detail is maintained. This can improve the quality and detail, in my opinion, by merging only on the pixel level and leaving larger sections as their original colors. Other than that, the compression step also takes some time to complete, so that has room for improvement as well. Well, I hope you enjoyed this little adventure with me into quadtree compression. It's certainly something new for me, especially doing this using Unity. Subscribe and stay tuned for the next episode, leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you next time.